Hey guys, welcome back to a new video, and in this video we are going to deep dive into some of the Kotlin keyword that you must know in order to increase your app performance. So we're going to deep dive into inline, crossinline, noinline, where and reified keyword, and these five keywords are very important for you to know as an Android developer. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So let's begin with very simple example in order to understand inline keyword, crossinline and noinline keyword. So I'm going to create a function naming print message, okay? And in this print message, I'm going to pass a lambda, which has no input parameter and return type is unit, and simply invoke it. Now I'm going to use this print message in our main function. So print message, print ln, this is message. Okay, so when you execute it, here you can see this is message. So you are not able to see any problem in this function. It's a very simple function, but there are few problems that I will show you in its bytecode. So to show the bytecode, go to this tools, Kotlin, show Kotlin bytecode, and simply decompile it. So now here you can see this is our decompile code. In our main function, we are having print message, and in the print message, we passed lambda. In our lambda, we don't pass any input parameter and the return type is unit. So in order to represent that lambda, what it did, it uses null, create its instance and typecast it into function zero. Function zero because in our lambda, we don't pass any input parameter. If you pass a single input parameter, then it will use function one. The real problem here is it uses instance in order to represent our lambda. And when it uses instance, eventually it allocates some memory to represent this lambda. So this is a problem. And in our mobile devices, we have very limited amount of resources. We don't want to waste our resources to represent lambda. So let's fix it. So go to our Kotlin keyword. And here in front of your print message, simply use inline keyword. And now when you execute it, you can see this is message. Now let's check out the bytecode. So now in our main function, this time we don't create any instance to represent our lambda. Instead of that, it simply cut out the function body and paste in our calling location. So go to our Kotlin keyword. What it did, it simply cut out this function body and paste in our main. But there are few problems comes with this approach. So I'm gonna use here print message again and print ln. This is second message. Okay, so when you execute it, you can see this is message, this is second message. But what will happen if I use here return keyword? When you execute this main function, this time we only receive this is message. As I told you, inline function will eventually cut out your function body and paste in your calling location. So what happened over here is it simply cut out this and paste in our main. So once it paste this code in our main, this return will eventually become main function return. So by looking, it looks like return of print message, but it is not. Under the hood, it simply cut this thing out and paste in our main. So it become non-local return. So what is local return and non-local return? So let's understand with a very simple function over here. So we are having a function A, and simply I'm going to use here return keyword. And when you use this A function on the top of our main and execute your main, it will never stop your main function execution because this return keyword is eventually a local return of your A function. So it will never become non-local return of any other function. But in case of our inline function, it simply cut your body and paste in your calling location. And due to that reason, sometimes it will become non-local return. So in order to fix this scenario, we are having one more keyword, and the keyword name is cross inline. And once you use here cross inline keyword, you can see we are having problem, and it's asked you specifically this return is specific to what function. So we have to tell this return is specific to our print message. And now when I execute it, here you can see we are able to see this is message and this is second message. So by using cross inline, you eventually prevent your return to become non-local return. So this is a use case of cross inline. So let's understand no inline keyword. So here I'm using no inline, and I'm going to pass a lambda, which is pretty much same signature wise. So we don't have any input parameter, and we are returning unit, and invoke it over here. And in place of this print message, I'm going to use pair of parentheses, and in place of A, I'm using these two things. Simply paste it over here, reformat it, and in place of P, I'm going to use print ln and call this is first B. Okay. And similarly for this function, I'm going to use a pair of parentheses and paste this thing in this particular block. Now this block belongs to B. I'm going to use print ln and call this is second B. Okay, so now when you execute it, here you can see this is message, this is first B, this is second message, this is second B. And when you are using return over here, so specifically you have to mention that this return belongs to our print message. So by using this, it eventually become a local return of your print message, and it will never stop the execution of your main function. Basically, this B function has a near about same property, just like we have this function. There are some problems with inline functions. So make sure when you use inline keyword with any function, that must have some lambda function as a parameter. Apart from this, if your lambda has a very huge body, then don't use inline keyword, because under the hood, inline keyword will eventually cut out this body and paste in your calling location. And this is not good when you are having function that has a huge body. So make a note of it when you are using inline keyword with any function. Your lambda must be minimal or small. Now it's time to use these keywords in our real world problem. So for that, go to videoplayer.kt, and here I am having a sealed class naming video that has three different subclasses in it: programming, cooking, and travel. And in our main function, I have a list of videos. So the first functionality what I'm gonna introduce over here is I want to filter this video list based on their subtypes. So how can we do that? Well, in order to do that, I'm gonna create a function and call this function filter. And in this filter, I'm gonna pass my list of video, and eventually it will return me list of type T. So basically it's a generic function. So in order to make this function generic, I'm gonna use here type T. Okay, now in this function body, I'm gonna use a return keyword, use my list, filter is instance, and the instance which you want to filter, you can simply pass over here. But the thing is, this type is not available in your function body in runtime. So to make use of this type T in our function body, we have one more keyword, which is reified. So by using a reified keyword, you can actually access the type T within your function body during runtime. But there are few problems with reified. Reified keyword is only used with inline keyword. So simply make this function inline. Now you can see we don't have any problem over here. So let's use this function in our main. So for using this, I'm gonna use here filter list variable, filter function, and I want to filter my list based on their programming subtype, and simply pass my videos list. In the last, I'm gonna use println and simply print my filter list. All right, so here you can see we are getting the programming list. Now I'm gonna introduce one more functionality which eventually used to transform this list of video. So for that, I'm gonna create an inline function, call this apply transformation. And in this, I'm gonna pass my list of videos on which I want to perform the transformation. Next, I'm gonna use here no inline keyword. And this is actually used to apply the transformation. So we are having transformation name. And in this, I'm gonna pass my video as an input parameter, and the return of this thing is transformed video. And lastly, I want to use crossinline on complete naming function, which eventually use my list of videos, basically the transform list of videos, and the return type of this function would be unit. Now I'm gonna use this list, eventually use map and apply the transformation, and take this thing in the filter list, not filter list, but you can use here transform list. And lastly, I'm gonna use my onComplete, invoke this thing with transform list. So let's use this apply transformation over here. So to use this, I'm gonna use apply transformation inline function, pass my list of videos. Next, we have to apply the transformation. So for that, we are having here transformation, which will eventually give me one by one my videos. So depending on the video subtypes, I'm gonna apply the transformation. So let's use the branches over here, and in the cooking, I'm gonna simply use my video, make a copy of it, and in the title, I'm gonna use its title, which is video.title, and add some transformation. And similarly for all of the branches. So I'm gonna copy this, paste it for the programming branch, paste it for the travel branch. Okay. And lastly, we have onComplete. So in the onComplete, we are receiving the list of transformed video. So here I'm gonna use it for each, and simply by using println, I'm gonna print the transformed video. Now when you execute it, here you can see we are having the filter one. This is our filter one result, and this is our transformation. So in the title, you can see Kotlin basics transformation, cooking with Kotlin transformation. So basically you can use this function to apply transformation. So if you look out this function is an inline function, which eventually uses a list of videos that you want to transform. And in the transformation, I use noinline because I don't want to make this function inline, and also I want all the properties of a normal function. Next, we are having crossinline. So as you already know, this crossinline is used to prevent our return from becoming non-local return. So this is a very simple function. So now I'm going to introduce one more functionality which eventually used to play all of this video. So for that, I'm going to create a class and call this play video. This is a generic class, okay? So type is T, and I want to restrict this type. I want to use only the type of video or its subtype. So to do it, I'm going to use here where keyword. So where T is a type of video or subtypes of video. Now, within this, I'm going to create a function and call this play video. And in this, I'm going to pass a list of type T. Now, in this play video, I'm going to use a list and perform the iteration. So when our type is programming, then I'm going to use println and simply use programming over here and use this arrow. And lastly, I'm going to simply use its title. Okay. So this is for the programming, and we are having travel. So for the travel, we are having same message, but with the travel one. Okay. And lastly, I'm going to use this thing, paste it over here. We are having cooking. So in place of travel, replace this thing with cooking. Now it's time to use this play video function. So go to your main function, and here I'm going to use wall. Call this play video and create a object of our play video. Type is video, and after that I'm going to use play video dot play video function, pass the list of videos, and when you execute it, here you can see this is programming, cooking, programming, travel. Okay, so these are all the keywords that you must know in order to optimize your app performance. And one more thing, if you want to restrict this reified type, then you can use here colon and simply type video. So this will eventually work just like where keyword. All right, so that's it for this video. I hope you got the actual idea about these keywords: inline, no inline, cross inline, reified, and the where. So where is eventually used to restrict this generic type in our classes. So this video is very helpful for those who never use these keywords. These keywords are very scary for a lot of developers, and due to this I make this video. Hope you like this video, and we will meet our next video where we will discuss some new topics about Android.